So today's topic for reference is protozoology. So if you have referred to my previous video of parasitology, mycology and phycology, which are basic terminologies related to microorganisms, which comes under microbiology. So in this video of protology, which basically consists of organisms such as protozoans, so we'll talk about them somewhat in details. Okay, so what are protozoans? Protozoans are microscopic single-celled organisms that are categorized according to their method of movement. So these are single-celled. Okay, first of all, they are single-celled, then they are microscopic structures, obviously, that's very obvious. Okay, that are categorized according to their methods of movements. So let's talk about their methods of movements. Okay, so coming to the methods of movement, there are four types of methods of movement for protozoans. So the first method is ciliates. Okay, and what are ciliates responsible for? These are only parasitic ciliates that causes disease in humans in Plantidium coli. These are only parasitic. Remember, this is very important. Parasitic cells that cause disease in humans. Okay, that is very important for you all to understand. What is it trying to explain? Okay, so, and I forgot to name the cell, which is the Balanitium coli. Okay, Balanitidium coli, pardon for the spelling. Next method of movement is flagellates. Okay, so next method of movement is the flagellates. These are three of the most common and medically significant cells that include Giardia, Lambinia, Trypanosome and Trichomonas vaginalis. Okay, these are some of the organisms that is that has flagellates for the method of movement for locomotion, which is very important for you all to understand. There are some of the examples such as Trypanosome. Okay, and some of the examples more such as trichomas, vaginalis. Okay, so the next method of movement is amoeba. Okay, so what is amoeba? It includes amoeba. Okay, amoeba includes the pathogenic amoeba Entamoeba and Endonimax, which causes dysentery in humans. Entamoeba and Endonimax, which are responsible for the causing of the disease named dysentery in humans. Okay, okay, so which is very important for you all to understand. So next, last site of method of movement, which is apicomplexa. What is apicomplexa? These have no special organs for movement. Okay, and these organisms include some of the examples of its organisms are toxoplasma, anything you spell according to your convenience. Okay, so this is something that you all need to know about protozoans and its types. Okay, so coming to the forms and reproduction in it, in the term protozoa. So let's talk about it. Okay, so let's talk about some of the forms and reproduction. Okay, okay, so these can survive in environments, and these are basically in infected forms known as cysts. This is the infected form. This can survive in environment, as I told you. So these are trophozoites. Okay. These are trophozoites, which are vegetative forms capable for reproduction. Okay, these are trophozoites that you need to know. So let's talk about its reproduction and main forms. What basically what it's asexual or sexual, let's talk about it. The first asexual means of reproduction in it is cysogamy. What is asexual method of reproduction? Cysogamy. Next is binary fission. Which is asexual means, as well as asexual means of reproduction, as I have mentioned in my videos, previous videos. And next is sporogamy, through spores, which is asexual means of reproduction in protozoans. Okay, so this is some of the basic information that you all need to know. So the term protozoa in this video of protology are present in blood and tissue protozoa. Okay, so it is present in blood and tissue protozoa. Examples such as Plasmodium special. It is also present in intestinal and urogenital protozoa, such as some of the examples are Entomoeba histolytica, Cryptosporidium. I'll write it for you for a better reference. Okay, so let's talk about its blood and tissue, as I told you, location and everything. Okay, so talking about its blood and tissue, its some of the examples are Plasmodium, so next location for this protozoa, the term protozoa is intestinal and urogenital protozoa. It's some of the examples to this are Entomoeba histolytica. Okay, so coming to the next part, some of the parts such as I explained you in this video, such as Entomoeba histolytica, they are some of the terms related to protozoans, and some of the principal tools which are as per the principal terms or protozoa which are related to this. Okay, so let's come to the last topic of this video, which is the principle of tool sampling collection and handling and processing for parasitic examination. So let's study this. What is it basically? It's the principle, which I'll repeat it. It's the principle of stool sampling collection and handling and processing for parasitic examination. So basically this is collection and handling, which means it has a minimum of 3 samples. Okay, next it's clean and watertight container with a screw capped, watertight container basically, and screw capped. next is the term is the smallest acceptable amount of stool is 2 to 5 grams. Okay, urine should be allowed to contaminate the specimen. Okay, so urine should be contaminated, I mean concentrated in a specimen, and the specimen container should be labeled correctly according to the name and the name of the patient and everything. So this was something that you need to know, which is important, which is the principle of stool sampling collection and handling. It's basically the principle of stool sampling collection and handling, so which is very important for the term protozoology, which comes under it, so which is a very widely used process. So this was the last part, as I told you. So that's it from my video of protozoology. So thanks for watching it. Thank you.